name is Claudia Dumshot. I'm the music director here. And we are so proud to present Matei Varga today in concert. You are all in for an incredible experience today. In addition to being one of the world's great pianists and an artist, he's also a beautiful human being and very kind, generous. He's a member of the church here, a parishioner, and we are so blessed to have him, to count him as a friend. So without further ado, Matei Varga.
I was a little afraid I may not fit there, but as long as I do, I'm glad, I'm happy. Happy Easter to all of you. Of course, we're still celebrating Easter, as Father John David said so well. But for me, it's actually a very special celebration too, because I was born into the Greek Orthodox religion. So today is actually our Easter. So it's a very special moment for me. And when Gloria asked me, would the 16th of April be okay as a day, I immediately said yes. And she said, you know, it's the Orthodox Easter. I said, yes, I know. But what better way of celebrating than to actually perform Beethoven? Well, perform anything, really. So I'm very, very glad that you are here. I see many wonderful, familiar faces. And I thank you for supporting me and supporting this wonderful place, which really is not only a beautiful place, but also very special, because this lovely lady and myself have got married last year here in that small chapel there. So, I know that you all came knowing that I will not only play, but also talk. So here I am. and also I hope that I will keep it short enough so that the talking will not be longer than the performance. But in any case, what I do want to say are a few words about tonight's program. Of course it's Beethoven, of course it's beautiful, and of course you probably came because you love these pieces. And so do I. Very, very much. But there's a little bit of a backstory to it. So I'll tell you. And tell me if I run over 20 minutes. as a young child, I was very fortunate to be discovered and then supported by a wonderful, wonderful Romanian artist, a great soprano, who performed at the Metropolitan Opera, at New York City Opera, at many, many major theaters in Europe. And when she finally came to Romania, where she was actually a persona non grata during the communist time, because she actually fled Romania, so she could never come back. But then, after the communist regime fell, she came back in 1991 and started to support the young generation of Romanians, which really is wonderful and very, very special. She was not only a great artist, but she was a great, great human being. Probably some of you know of her. I should hope so, because she really is a very important name in the opera world, Mariana Nicolescu. So, I was about 10 or 11, and I performed a recital in Bucharest, and I was videotape, which was much more of a big deal then than it is now, where everything is live streamed. And so somehow that tape got into her hands, and she liked my performance very much. And so as of, you know, the time when I was 12, we met, she discovered me, she then invited me to events, she supported my career. She was actually instrumental in my coming to New York and meeting the first patron I have here. Anyway, we stayed in touch, and she organized a wonderful voice festival and competition in Romania, where I went many times, and Missy and I went several times together, and we were treated like royalty every single time, and I performed there, and we were so happy to support and to listen to the young singers and to be part of this great event. In 2020, actually late 2019, Mariana Nicolescu emailed me or called me and said, would you please come to this festival and do a Beethoven program? Because in 2020, we had a big Beethoven celebration, right? So I said, of course, sure. And I sent her a program, which was a little bit like the one we're going to listen to tonight, but not identical. So she got my email. She called me back and said, little cheap, because that's how she would call me. Don't you just love the idea of my being a little cheeky? But to her, I was a little cheeky, and I guess will always be. I said, why don't you do the Pathétique and the Moonlight and the Appassionata? And of course, like all reluctant children, I all, but you never say no to her, okay? You could never say no to her. So I said, sure, I'll do it. So I kind of started preparing this program, and then, of course, you all know, COVID came. So that performance with this exact program never happened. And so last year, in 2022, Missy and I went to Brazil, where this competition and festival takes place. We met, of course, Mariana and her husband, and I played a different program in the festival because, of course, it was no longer Beethoven's year. But she said, you know, we still need to do the Beethoven program. We'll do it next year, because this year was supposed to be a very big celebration, 25 years since they started. So it was the right, even though it was no longer the Beethoven year, but it was the right moment to do it. In October of last year, I was in the Cayman Islands performing a recital there, and I opened my phone to the news that Mariana has died. Oh. After a short but very difficult illness. So of course, this program will probably never happen there, but it is happening here tonight for you and for her. So I hope you will enjoy.
Thank you.